they are observing from you. Set a good example. Let's open a new chapter in this country. Let's open a new chapter in this country. A chapter that will bring progress. A chapter that will create wealth for our country. Do not be vested 100% in politics. Please, no. Please, no. You have an opportunity to change the political course of this nation. God bless you. God bless the Zambian people. Thank you.
Thank you, Bachimba, and good night. Thank you for coming. I know you have to go. Thank you so much. Baanik, the floor is yours. We can wind down.
Bachimba, my brother, I'm asking you to just give, he's gone.
He's listening, you can talk.
Mama Pumulo, today I hear the standing orders in parliament are being changed. Democracy once again is being vandalized. Is it okay to see a head of state support lawlessness by raping the constitution, by supporting the Mao Sampa faction in a bid to kill opposition? We have all seen his interaction with Honorable Chavinga, a man that was dubiously placed as leader of opposition. Again, imingalato of Mr. HH. We have all seen on social media. Mama Pumulo, today I prayed about coming on this program. I put everything in prayer. I'll share a story of how I met Mr. Hakainde Hichilema 23 years ago. I lost my father. My father was working for the Intercontinental Hotel. And he died on the 20th of May, 2021. And Mr. Hakainde Hichilema was the liquidator of Zambia Hotel Properties. Twafumile mukushika batata. And we got home and we found the house was locked. It was locked. I took a drive to Grand Thornton then, in tears, and met with Mr. Hakainde Hichilema in the boardroom. And to say the least, I was abused in the conversation that I had with Mr. Hakainde Hichilema, because I could not believe that a Zambian born in Zambia, bred in Zambia, would disrespect the dead. My father had an issue of rentals being increased that did not warrant the increment. It was a 4,000 kwacha. And while crying, Mr. HH told me, go and look for the money and come and pay. I tried to tell him that I am the administrator and I needed to be given a bit of time, as the house that was being locked, there was a funeral. Mr. Hakainde Hichilema did not want to hear of it and said to me, we close our offices at 4:15. Go and find the money and come and pay. I ran around. I got to Grand Thornton at 3:30 and I paid that rental area that my father had. And Mr. Hakainde Hichilema gave me two officers to go and open the funeral house. I was shocked, to say the least. I was shocked because that's very un-African. But guess what, Mr. Akainde? I have forgiven you. I have released you. You hurt me. You hurt me so much because I was brought up by that man single-handedly. We were brought up by my father with no mother. And I said, God help you. And from that day, I realized what type of a person you are. God bless you, HH. I wish you the best. Today, I've decided to release you. I have released you. You are a bitter man. You never forgive. But today I forgive you for what you did. God bless you, Richard.
Anik, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I really, you know, that is quite a burden you have carried all these years. You know, that is a burden. It is a burden when you were abused by somebody, and then you see that same person abusing other people, it just opens the wounds. You know, it opens the wounds because you are reminded of the same thing you went through. And I don't even really know what to say, but just let's keep Anik in our prayers. We pray for strength, and we thank you for sharing. That is something very deep, and you know, I met Anik. We met on this page, and we have become friends. And Anik shared what happened to her, her encounter with HH. And I told Anik the first time she told me the story, she has managed to come out in the open and share today. The first time Anik told me about her story, I said, Anik, why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you tell me when I was campaigning for HH about this story? Because never in a million years can I ever campaign for someone. I don't care who you are, but I would not support somebody who treats people when they are down. Anik had lost her father, and like you heard, she came from the funeral, from the burial. Mourners were languishing outside. I don't know what they did, but you know, we respect funerals, we respect the loss of somebody But Anik has been carrying this wound for so many years. And now this same man who wounded her is now the president and busy wounding other people. You know, it is so sad, really. But Anik, be strong. You know, at least you have come out to forgive him openly. And I hope he can find ways to make amends to you. And for me, I just think that if I were HH, I would just treat people better, you know. I'm going to cut this clip of Anik's message and circulate it, because I think people need to know. People need to know what a kind of a president we have. And I think going to the future, let us do background check. Let us check people we appoint to be leaders. Are they human? You know, do they care for people, you know? Because obviously this hasn't changed, you know. This hasn't changed. HH's personality hasn't changed. And now that he even has the power, his power is just abusing Zambians. And it is so sad. Yeah, so I think we end here. I have nothing to say, really, but just to comfort me. You know, I remember when I lost my dad. I remember every second, every minute, because a parent is the most important person in your life, you know. So if you have your mother and your father in your life, they are the most important people in your life. They teach you everything you know. They make you are them, you know. And when in their last days, that is supposed to be respected, you know. A funeral of somebody's father should be respected. Even if he's not your father, he's somebody's father, it means a lot to them. Is somebody's mother, it means a lot to them. So it is just sad, really. It's just sad, you know. And I don't know what to say, but I just hope HH, he did it as his capacity as HH, as a businessman, so we shall address him as such. What he did to Anik and Anik's family, he needs an apology. He need to come clean and apologize to Anik and her family. Otherwise, our Mwandin wafia Mwandin. Hello, I don't know how it, you know, just to Anik and their family to see HH become president and start mistreating Zambians. We have seen this over and over again, you know. Kukasompi okobarito baya potamayanda, kuchalala barito belabantu. It's just like, you know, mistreating people, like no empathy and sympathy. No empathy and sympathy to a point where I'm sure Anik never wanted to reveal this to the whole world, but she has just seen how this man, now president, is just mistreating people, you know? I'm sure Anik never in a million years did Anik wants to come and start talking about this. But she has seen the injustice by this same man, HH. We shall refer to him as HH, because when he did what he did to Anik, he wasn't a president. He was just a CEO of some company. So what HH did to Anik, I don't think Anik wanted to ever bring this public. But she has been pressured to bring this public by his behavior. He is not relenting and he is not stopping, you know, in mistreating people. And the more he's mistreating people, the more he's opening more wounds. So people now, they are like, Anik's wound has opened. You know, she has broken down. You have seen the tears. We are crying with her. Because sometimes you just feel so helpless. And you just cry and share your story, you know. And Anik, thank you so much for sharing your story. You know, I still miss my parents up to now. I miss my dad. I miss my mom. They are both deceased. I remember their funerals very well. Both my parents, I remember, that's the last time I've ever seen my parents is on the funeral. And those are memorable days. I remember everything. They had respectable funeral. But for you, Anik, your dad's funeral was, it was confusion at the end. So that's painful. That is a memory that you have to take with to your grave. To remember how your dad's funeral turned out to be a nightmare. Instead of you mourning your dad, you were driving around and trying to find money because your house was locked. Because the person couldn't wait. They couldn't give you 24 hours to grieve. Or even a week to say, next week, let's give them time to mourn. You were not given time to properly mourn your dad. And that is very, it's hurtful. It's painful. And now to see that same person who denied you of a proper funeral of your father, who embarrassed you, that person embarrassed you, that person humiliated your family. That person, you know, was just mean to you when you are mourning. Inena, you know, like me personally, there are people I have friends. When my mother died, they never sent me a whatever. She was social number. There are people who never supported me during my funerals of my parents. I have cut ties with them. So what? You know, Anik, thank you for sharing. I hope you are okay. I'll call you in a minute. Viewers, earlier Shiyo, some of these people, mom, kula bula fi abantu mom send that ni pres, mom perech bo. Tule moena, tule shining kisha, tule la pila. Tulela pila. Bari tuewa nifimbo poke tulenya tulela pila. Tule shini inkisha. I just wish some of these stories came to light in the campaign 2021. Because inenga shaye sheshe, I would not in a million ways, in a million days, whatever, I would never have campaigned for HH. Have I known what I know today? Ili nedia shina mpareo from Anik. Ah, mwanzini. I wouldn't have campaigned for PF and I would not have campaigned for HH. This story that I've heard from Anik today is what has for me. The only thing I can say, too bad I didn't know this in 2021 is all I can say. Too bad. Because had I known this story, I would never have campaigned for HH. Yes. So good night, people. Thank you. And keep Anik in your prayers. And let's just hope she'll be able, you know, to take it easy. You know, it's a pain. This is something that is so painful, you know. We don't even know. We don't even know what to say. Katwish. Omo winga filo shakatwish. But we just need to pray for her and support her in whatever way we can. God bless you. Thank you.